Hi, this is COMP1010 at the University of Manitoba. I'm Dr. Celine LaTulip, and today I'm going to be talking to you about ordered insertion with arrays. So, in order to do binary search, we need to have a sorted list. And one of the easiest ways to achieve this is to just always keep your list or your array sorted. And the way to do this is to always add items in sorted order. So, every time we add an item, we're going to make sure that it goes into the right place to maintain that sorted order. So, for example, here, if we have a new item, 4, that we want to put into this array of integers, we don't want to just throw it at the end here after the 9, because that would mean that this array would no longer be sorted. We want to actually put it in here right between the 3 and the 5. So how do we go about doing this? The old way of adding stuff to arrays is to just add things at the end with a pointer to where the next empty slot is. And that's not going to work here. So what we're going to do is we're going to follow this algorithm. And the idea in this algorithm is that we're going to work actually from the end of the list, from the far right of the list, and we're going to move backwards towards the front. But what we're going to do is, as we move back towards the front of the list, we're going to move each item one spot to the right, until we get to the point where our new item that we want to insert is actually bigger than the current item, and then we're going to insert it. So the algorithm looks like this. We're going to pass in an array, in this case, an array of integers. We're going to pass in how many slots are filled, which is n. Then we're going to pass in the new item that we want to stick into our array in sorted order. And then we're going to have an index into where we're currently working in the array, and that's going to be n minus 1, because if we have 10 slots filled, we want to actually start at slot 9, because we count from 0. And we're going to have a Boolean that says, have we yet found the spot to put the item in? And we're going to initially just set that to false. And then what we're going to do is we're going to loop and keep on looping while the index that we're keeping track of is greater than 0, because we don't want to go off the left end of the array, and while we haven't yet found a spot. And we're going to compare the value in the array at that index, see how it compares to the item we're trying to insert. If it's bigger than the item we're trying to insert, we're going to move that item over one to the right, and then change our index to move over one slot to the left. So let's just sort of have a look at what this looks like, and we'll go through it with an example. So first we actually get into this method, ord insert, and we have again n, which is the number of filled slots. In this case we have 6, because there are 6 slots filled in this array. We have data, which is our pointer to the array, and we have new item, the thing that we want to insert. So in this case we want to insert the value 5. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to create a local variable called index. We're going to set it to n minus 1, so that will be 5, and that will allow us to point at the last filled slot in our array. And we're going to set our Boolean spot found to false, because we haven't yet found the spot to put our new item into. Okay. And then we're going to check our loop condition. While our index is greater than or equal to 0, and our index is 5, so we're good. And while we haven't yet found the spot, spot found is false, so not false is true. So this all turns out to be true in this case. Now we're going to do a comparison. We're going to look at what's in data at index. So at index 5, what's in our data is 9, and we're going to compare it to new item. New item is 5. So 9 is bigger than 5. And so what we're going to do then is we're going to copy what's in this index into the slot to the right. So data of index plus 1, which is this slot, gets a copy of what's in data of index, which is this slot. So we've basically just copied this value into the slot to the right. Okay. And then we decrement index so that we move one slot to the left so that we can keep on working through this array. So now we check our condition again. Index is still greater than 0. We still have spot found as false. And so now we're going to compare what's in slot 4, which is 8, 8 is still bigger than 5, and we're going to copy 8 into the slot to the right, and then we're going to decrement our index. So we're going to do this again. Index is still greater than 0. Spot found is still false. What's in index 3 is 7, so 7 is bigger than 5, and we copy it to the slot to the right. And we decrement our index, so now we're pointing at slot 2. And now we're pointing at slot 2, and the value in slot 2 is 4. And we're checking, is 4 greater than the item we want to insert, which is 5? This is not true any longer, and so we're not going to do any moving over and copying. And now what all we're going to do in response to this condition being false, in this else part of the if, we set spot found to true. So here spot found is true. And that means that when we come back up to our while loop, this is no longer going to be true, because false of true is false. And so then in the next thing that we're going to do is we've gotten out of our while loop because that condition was no longer true. And now we're going to say data at index plus 1. So index is pointing at 2. This slot before was 7, but we'd copied it over. So the slot was kind of an unused slot. And now we're actually putting our new item into that unused slot. And it's exactly where we want it to be. The 2 is in between the 4 and the 7.